Let us bow our heads in prayer. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. As we gather here today to celebrate the 2021 graduating class of the Masters of Arts in Biomedical Sciences program and watch them step forward into the next chapter of their lives, we ask for your almighty hand to be upon them. We are thankful for Bluefield College and the Edward Vyer College of Osteopathic Medicine, who have given them a safe place to learn and a strong foundation to build upon. We are also grateful for faculty, staff, and administration who have given so richly of their time and talents, for their families who have prayed, loved, cheered, listened, stood by their sides, cared for, and given monetarily, we give thanks. Thank you for wisdom and clear direction over their lives, and give them understanding beyond their years. We pray that you would direct their steps, that every place you have determined for them to walk be made clear. We ask you to open, for you to open doors that need to be opened and close every one that should be shut. Allow every gift you have placed inside them to grow, develop, and flourish. As these graduates embark upon their respective careers, let them be reminded of the prophetic words of Micah: do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly before you. Bless the works of their hands as they give glory, honor, and praise to you. In your name we pray, amen. Please remain standing for the scripture reading.
The word of God today comes from Colossians 3, selected verses. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another. And if one has a complaint against another, forgive each other. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, with a thankfulness in your heart to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give thanks to God the Father through him. Whatever you do, work heartily, as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Christ.
You may be seated. Well, good morning, graduates, guests, and members of the college community who are joining us for this graduation celebration. Graduates, you did it! We will not forget the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic that has had on our lives, our communities, our nation, and the world. And you have worked hard to get to this milestone. You have increased your knowledge. You have fought the challenges of remote. You persevered. All who are gathered here today, your families, your friends, your classmates, we're all here to celebrate your achievement. So this day is in honor of you. This morning we are honored to have Dr. Jan Wilcox with us today as our commencement speaker, and I'll be sharing more about her later in today's ceremony. Coming to the podium following my comments will be Trustee Julie Johnson, who will be bringing greetings to you on behalf of the Board of Trustees. Others participating in this morning's ceremony are Dr. Marshall Flowers, Vice President for Academic Affairs, Ms. Jean Herndon, Assistant Director of Education Programs, who gave our invocation, Dr. Emily Lambert, Associate Professor of Biology, who read Scripture, followed later by Mr. David Petey, Assistant Professor and Director for the Center for Worship Arts, who is being accompanied by Ms. Alandra Bloom. Dr. Brian Hill, Director of Master of Arts and Biomedical Sciences Program, Mr. Zach Smith, President of the Alumni Association Board, and Dr. Ward Stevens, Associate Professor of Biomedical Studies. Graduates, today a chapter of your life story ends as a new one begins. And as you have been prepared over this past year to pursue your aspirations to serve in the medical profession, I hope you will also pursue an enjoyable and meaningful life, one grounded in faith and given to caring for and serving others. Much has been entrusted to you, and much is expected. Graduates, congratulations again on this achievement, and I challenge you to model what it means to be a servant leader. Go make a positive impact in the world. The world certainly needs it. May God bless you in immeasurable, exciting, and extraordinary ways. Godspeed.
Good morning. It is such a great privilege to be with you today to bring you greetings from the Bluefield College Board of Trustees and a hearty congratulations to our graduates, your family, and friends. And I'm sure you stand on the shoulders of many who have helped you rise to where you are today. You've made it and you've met so many challenges. What challenges we've had over the past year for everyone. You've zoomed in, you've zoomed out. There have been essential oils and essential employees. You've had remote learning, maybe some virtual dating. We've binge watched, we've eaten and binged, and we flattened the curve, and our curves have expanded. So, and what little socialization we have received is often the UPS or FedEx truck pulling out of our driveway. Unprecedented times. We've had shortages. First of all was toilet paper. Hand wipes, sanitizer, now gasoline. There's been shortage of hugs, handshakes, and haircuts. But most difficult, I think, was announced recently that now Chick-fil-A has a sauce shortage. What are we to do? But you have arrived, and have you ever overcome? Keep in mind that Jesus was a healer. You are in the healing arts. Keep that in mind. And our prayers are with you. They've been with you. They'll follow you out into the world. You're answering life's calling, and you're fulfilling a spiritual gift of healing. You'll heal others through their mind, body, and spirit, no matter what arena of the medical field you land in. Carry BC's beacon of light for us to the world, and may God richly bless you.
The Master of Arts and Biomedical Sciences faculty have selected the following two students to represent the graduates as today's speakers, Ms. Numa Salem Romani and Mr. Chinadum Inkamakalam. Numa Romani is a recent graduate of the University of Virginia, where she earned her undergraduate degree in psychology. And during her time at UVA, she worked in the Connolly Neuroscience Lab and was a member of Alpha Phi Omega. She looks forward to many more years of learning. Numa, we look forward to hearing you.
Good morning, everyone. It's so nice to see you all in person. Thank you to the Bluefield and VCOM staff and faculty for making today possible. I'd also like to give a big thanks to our friends and family for joining us today. I would like to start my speech with one word, opportunity. This is the one word my parents had in mind when they left everything behind to bring me and my sister to America. It was a chance for a better education and a better life. When I think about the MABS program, the same word comes to mind. I have admired and so greatly appreciated the MABS mission, which is to provide an opportunity to especially those students from low socioeconomic backgrounds, rural areas, and underrepresented minorities. The MABS program aims to produce future physicians who will address the needs of the underserved and advocate for healthcare accessibility. This program does a wonderful job of finding these students too, as this is the most outstanding group of people I've ever met. I have never experienced an academic community like the one I've found through this program. We all wanted the best for each other. We wanted to ensure that every single person in this program was thriving. Anytime someone created a study resource for themselves, they would be sure to share it with everyone else. Countless study guides, flashcard decks, mnemonics, and YouTube videos later, here we all are with our master's degree. In all my years of schooling, I was always surrounded by people who wanted to keep everything to themselves in order to get ahead. This was never the case with this group. I want to emphasize again, this is an extraordinary group. It's been a difficult year for all of us, but we found ways to accomplish what we wanted to. This year, our program was almost entirely virtual. Being remote could have easily caused students to fall behind and feel isolated from other students and professors. However, this group of students did not let the screens become an obstacle between excelling in their academics as well as making a connection with each other and the professors. For example, Dr. Palmieri is retiring this year, and on the last day of class, we all made posters for him and put them up to the camera for him to see on Zoom. Speaking of Dr. Palmieri, the faculty is phenomenal. I will never forget what Dr. Palmieri said the day after one of our hardest exams. Medicine is what you do, not who you are. Take care of who you are. I think many of us had forgotten that, and we were reducing ourselves to numbers. We needed that reminder to cultivate ourselves in order to be the best physicians for our future patients. Every single faculty member taught us something valuable, and they did it in the middle of a pandemic. My mom's probably in tears by now, so I better finish up this speech. Looking for her. Before I do, I would like to leave you with the following quote by His Highness the Aga Khan. The road to a more cooperative world does not require us to erase our differences, but to understand them. Looking around this quad, I see people from all different backgrounds, with each of us having unique stories and lessons to contribute. I see a brighter America ahead that embraces and values all our differences. As we continue our journey to becoming healthcare providers, please remember to stay true to yourself and honor the truth of those who surround you. Congratulations to the MABS Class of 2021.
Chinadoom studied at the College of Staten Island, where he obtained his Bachelor of Science degree in psychology in 2018 and afterwards worked as a medical scribe in the ER prior to beginning the Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences degree program. Chinadoom has a passion for helping others and believes that anyone can achieve anything they truly set their mind to. He is about to complete the MABS program with a 4.0 GPA in both the fall and spring semesters. He has been accepted to the VCOM Carolinas campus for the class of 2025. Chinadoom's future goal is to serve as a physician in medically underserved areas of America in order to alleviate the healthcare disparities experienced by those living in rural communities. Chinadoom, I look forward to your words.
Good morning, everyone. I'm not sure my speech may be up to par with Numa's, but let's see what I can do here. So thank you to the president, faculty, trustees, graduating students, and all people that were invited, family and invitees. It's with total humility and a deep feeling of honor that I stand here today before all of you, chosen as one of the speakers for my fellow graduating MABS students. Education in the entire world is an important tool for shaping one's future. And most times, the institution where this education is acquired matters a whole lot. And having been here for the past 9 months, I can say without a doubt that Bluefield is one of those institutions where first-class education is acquired. And the MAPS program, from my personal experience, has been very difficult, but second to none. Is the MAPS program tough and challenging? The answer is unequivocally yes. However, it is in fact that difficulty that brings out the best in all of us as we strive day by day to achieve academic excellence. I can recall many periods during the program when I felt extremely overwhelmed. But during those times, I would always recall my father's words, "Nothing good comes easy." My parents, for that matter, are both Nigerian immigrants who, by working hard, were able to achieve great things and in their own rights are both successful American success stories. When I think about everything that my parents had to go through to get to where they are today, it serves as a constant reminder to me to never allow any obstacle to be permanent. The knowledge and confidence acquired in this program will no doubt make all of our next moves into medical school or any professional program a much smoother transition. Don't ever be discouraged by the workload and its attendant difficulties, because in time, it will come to an end and you will be duly rewarded. Finally, I want to once again thank all of the professors who made our time here so very valuable, not only in the academic sense, but also in the sense of many of the funny memories and life lessons that we'll all carry along with us as we continue along our journey. And to all of my fellow MAP graduates today, I would like to say, fasten your seatbelts and be prepared for the trip ahead, because only he or she who sows will have something to harvest at the end of the day. In closing, the last 3 points I would like to leave all of my fellow graduates with today would be: 1, be extremely stubborn for your success. 2, never allow your pursuit of the future to overshadow all of your current accomplishments. And lastly, in the words of Dr. Paul Mary, please, 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 please don't kiss your dog. Thank you.
I'm going to invite everyone to stand, please, and take your program. Our scripture admonished us to speak to one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. And that comes from the same Bible that says, make a joyful noise. And so even if you're not a singer, I invite you to just sing heartily as we join this hymn together. Holy, holy, holy.
Sky and
It's my privilege to introduce to you our commencement speaker today, Dr. Jan Wilcox. She is the Dean and Professor of Family Medicine for the Virginia campus of the Edward Via College of Osteopathic Medicine. She joined VCOM in 2001 as the founding Associate Dean of Clinical Academic Affairs and played an integral role in the development of VCOM's curriculum and medical education programs. Dr. Wilcox has previously served as the Regional Dean for Kirksville College of Osteopathic Medicine in Mesa, Arizona. She also served as the Director of Medical Education for the KCOM Arizona Osteopathic Postgraduate Programs and the Medical Director for the Physician Assistance Program. Dr. Wilcox has over 20 years of experience in higher education administration and was recognized as the guardian of the profession by the American Osteopathic Association. Dr. Wilcox is a distinguished fellow of the American College of Osteopathic Family Physicians. She serves on the Board of Deans and as chair on the International Collaborative Steering Committee of the American Association of Colleges of Osteopathic Medicine. She also serves on the Board of Trustees of the Osteopathic International Alliance, as well as on the Board of Directors for the Medical Society of Virginia. As a preceptor, Dr. Wilcox accompanies Appalachian and international outreach experiences for VCOM. Dr. Wilcox is the vice chair and AACOM representative on the Bureau of International Osteopathic Medicine of the American Osteopathic Association. She also serves as a member of the Board of Directors for the Southwest Virginia Area Health Education Center. Dr. Wilcox received her DO degree from the Kirksville College of Osteopathic Medicine in Kirksville, Missouri. She is board certified in family medicine, and she completed her postgraduate training at Osteopathic Hospital of Wichita in Wichita, Kansas. She has practiced in solo private practice in Jinx, Oklahoma, and large multi-specialty medical practice settings in Phoenix, Arizona, in family medicine for over 20 years. Now, with a pedigree such as that, it's amazing that Dr. Wilcox has time to do all the things that she does in investing herself into the lives of students who attend VCOM. But Dr. Wilcox, we are grateful for your accomplishments, but more importantly, your presence with us here today. We look forward to hearing your inspiring words.
I'm sure the students here are really disappointed that I don't have a PowerPoint, but we'll manage one without one. Thank you, Bluefield College Board of Trustees, Dr. Olive, Dr. Flowers, Dr. Hill, and members of the stage party. And of course, I'm a big fan of Miss Jean Herndon, as we all are. I'd like to begin by congratulating the graduates of Bluefield College Masters of the Arts Biomedical Science Program offered in partnership with Edward Via College of Osteopathic Medicine. I'm here not only to honor your academic success, but also your resilience, which has sustained your success through a difficult period. At a time of a worldwide pandemic and a year filled with so much pain, while witnessing racial injustices, you are here preparing to enter the world of healthcare. This graduating class is stepping into professions that are being asked to do more than has ever been done before. You've learned much this year about the art and science of medicine. Each of you have faced your own challenges and also struggles this year. Many of you have not been able to share in some of the family celebrations or care for family members. And some of you have even lost loved ones during this time. One of my favorite quotes from this year is from Margaret Gobrin, also known as Mama Maggie, CEO and founder of Stevens Children, an organization that cares for orphan children in the most dire, poverty-stricken areas of Cairo. She said, "The stronger the wind, the stronger the tree." As students, you've faced a pandemic and you've been courageous, innovative, and you've developed an immense resilience. It's your hard work and commitment that has brought you to the finish line of your studies here and to the starting line of your professional careers. and to the rest of your lives, really. This is a big day, and I know that you will enjoy it and remember it. I also want to congratulate all the parents and families of the graduates. Your support of these students is essential to what they've achieved. It's your moment, too, so please enjoy it. Graduates, do not forget to thank your friends and family and loved ones and others who were involved in your progress to get you throughout this program. I have the honor to know many graduates of this program. You have a reputation. It's a really good reputation. I've seen your ability to hit the ground running, to problem solve, to balance curricular requirements while contributing to your communities. I've seen graduates of this program successfully take on leadership roles. I've seen them create and provide welcoming, positive, supportive space for their peers. That will be you. While many of you are pursuing a career in osteopathic medicine at one of our VCOM 4 campuses and other colleges of osteopathic medicine, others have chosen careers in other healthcare fields. Some of you will take advantage of new programs such as avenues developed by Bluefield College, such as dual degrees and master's education. Some of you will be attending the Appalachian College of Pharmacy and other schools of pharmacy. Some will take advantage of the opportunities through VCOM's affiliations with Wingate University in areas such as physical therapy, occupational therapy, or physician assistant. Regardless of the path you take, the education you've received here will serve as a strong foundation. Additionally, as you move forward in your career, I encourage each of you to seek out mentors and utilize their wisdom. Personally, I've been very blessed to have so many wonderful mentors in my life that has inspired me throughout my career. One of my biggest mentors is my mother, who is 96 and still lives in the same farmhouse where I grew up in Kirksville, Missouri, where osteopathy was founded. Talk about resilience. During this pandemic, she has sewn and donated over 500 masks to help other people. From the moment I turned 16, I began working in the local hospital lab. My boss at that time was a female anesthesiologist who instilled professionalism and ethics in all of us who worked in that lab. She was the sole anesthesiologist for a small hospital when women at that time accounted for only 9% of all U.S. medical school enrollment. Another mentor of mine was a male radiologist at that hospital who took me to a Rotary Club meeting at a time when women were not allowed in the door. As my friend and mentor, Barbara Ross Ledio, the first black female dean of any U.S. medical school, says, it's not just about asking someone to be your mentor. Show up and do something. It's not the mentor's job. It's on you. And as my friend and another dear mentor, William G. Anderson, D.O., says, he's the first black president of the American Osteopathic Association, also the only one, so some of you might keep that in mind as you move forward in the profession. He's also the president of the Albany Movement, which fought for civil rights, and he has told me a few times over the last year, look for the silver linings. They may be really hard to find. They may be thin and wispy, but there are silver linings. Take a moment to think about all the great friends you've made here. Make a vow to keep them with you. They will help you more than you know in your journey. Stay in touch with each other and your mentors. Your paths can cross in so many ways, regardless of your next step in your professional life. Reflect back to these friendships and strength and resilience of your study groups. It's a small world, and you may find yourselves living in the same community as a classmate, or you may be able to support each other's goals by being present, and as you know, even virtually, that works pretty well, positive and available to their needs. You are accountable for all that you do. Today's commencement is not the end of your journey, but rather a springboard to bring other opportunities into the realm of possibility. Take your training and your knowledge forward to serve those most in need. And no matter where you go, keep in mind the osteopathic principles of body, mind, and spirit, and treat the whole patient. I trust that each of you will make a lasting impact on those around you as you move forward, and I cannot wait to see all that you can accomplish as a class. Do something you love every day. You're awesome. It's been an honor to address you today and your families as well. Thank you for that honor.
I'd like to ask Dr. Jim Palmieri to come forward, please. Dr. Palmieri has been with the MABS program since its inception and has been with the precursor of the program a number of years before that. And he first came over teaching a portion of the microbiology program, and when Dr. El-Swafi moved on, he took over the microbiology program. When I had an opening that I needed someone to teach the research course, and it needed some fresh blood in it, I couldn't think of anybody better than Dr. Palmieri with his enthusiasm being there. And when we brought in a brand new faculty fresh out from her PhD that I wanted somebody to help mentor Dr. Megan Wilson, couldn't think of anybody better than putting her in that research course with Dr. Palmieri. It's bittersweet that he's graduating. I know he has many things in his life that he looks forward to doing here in retirement, but we got him a plaque here just to commemorate him and just to thank him for all that he's done. I'd like to read it here. It says, Dr. Jim Palmieri, all good things come to an end. So is true for the marvelous and memorable contributions you have made to the MABS program. Your knowledge, your devotion, and your mentorship have left an indelible mark on your colleagues and even more so on your students. A workplace is never quite the same when someone like you departs. We wish you a triumphant, delightful, and wonderful retired life ahead. Dr. Palmieri, thank you. Let's get a picture here. Can I say a few words to students?
It's not often I'm at loss for words. Thank you very much to the faculty and the administration. I've been trying to retire for 4 or 5 years, and I keep coming back. I've taught for about 54 years, and I saved the best for last. You guys are rock stars. You knocked it out of the park. You worked so hard, and when you handed in the case reports they had to write, which was really the culmination of the research course in the microbiology, they were by far the best I've seen in my 18 years here. And I thank you for that. When you move forward, just remember, you be you, and you'll be successful. Next year, when you are sitting with other students, they've trained for the 5K, you guys have already run the marathon. So you can be looked upon as leaders and study groups and such. If I could ask a favor of you, this is a beautiful plaque. Could everybody just pull down their masks for like a second so I could see your face, so I can have a memory that goes along with this? Thank you very much. Love you guys.
And his wife, Mrs. Karen Palmieri, is right with him on the front row. I'd like everybody to give her a hand as well. Karen.
Good morning. Just a little insight into the fact that a shooting range is just over the mountain here. And if you hear some of those shots ringing, just realize it's a shooting range for our local justice police officers. So, and then, of course, we have a lot of flag action here today. So sorry about that. Bluefield College trustees, President Olive, distinguished guests, esteemed faculty, family, and friends, the degree conferral ceremony commences now with the presentation of the candidates for the graduation from Bluefield College's Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences degree program, offered in partnership with the Edward Via College of Osteopathic Medicine in Blacksburg, Virginia. I'd like to share with you several facts about the class of 2021. First of all, there are 107 graduates. We have approximately 75 to 80 that have joined us today. There are a total of 71 female graduates, a total of 36 male graduates. There are students with international countries for birth origin, 19 in total. Let me mention those countries: Bangladesh, Cambodia, Canada, El Salvador, Germany, India, Iran, Iraq, Mexico, Pakistan, and Serbia. There are 88 students from 24 states across the United States: Alabama, Arizona, California, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Illinois, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Mississippi, Missouri, Nebraska, New Jersey, New York, North Carolina, Ohio, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, Texas, Virginia, and West Virginia. There is a sister and a brother among the graduates. One student is getting married just 2 weeks from today. There are a number of first-generation students among the graduates. There are 5 students from the same neighborhood who graduated from the same high school and graduated from the University of Houston and are now graduating from Bluefield College Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences degree program. Will the candidates for the degree Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences please rise? Dr. Olive, these candidates have met all requirements for the Master of Arts degree in Biomedical Sciences, as evidenced in the exhibition of their academic achievement, and have been approved by the faculty. The degree Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences requires the successful completion of 35 credit hours of master's level study within a 10-month academic year, a very intensive program.
On behalf of the faculty and by virtue of the power vested in me by the Bluefield College Board of Trustees and the Commonwealth of Virginia, I now confer upon you the degree of Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences with all of the rights and privileges thereunto appertaining.
Will the first candidates for the degree of Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences please come forward? The remaining candidates may be seated.
Chandani Aguera from Wake Forest, North Carolina. Usud Iman Uli from Charlottesville, Virginia. Sarah Catherine Banning from Glen Carbon, Illinois. Roxana Beruz from Glen Allen, Virginia. Nicholas Edward Bishop from LaGrange, Georgia. Harth Blankenship from Ranchville, South Carolina. Brendan Bordwine from Elkins, West Virginia. Fiona Catherine Bradshaw from Charlottesville, Virginia. Caitlin Braffett from Florence, South Carolina. Tristan Lee Budd from North Muskegon, Michigan. Sydney Paige Calhoun from Louisville, Kentucky. Jaspreet Chahal from Fairfax, Virginia. Christopher Matthew Connolly from Parisburg, Virginia. Yaziman Dostagoli from Germantown, Maryland. Dean Lake from from Richmond, Virginia. Connor Ryan Duke from Springfield, Illinois. Neil Garg from Potomac, Maryland. Nicole Alexa Gentile from Marietta, Georgia. Nicole Simone Hickman from Bishopville, South Carolina. Gianna Horsley from Marlton, New Jersey. Kimbriana Hunter from Anderson, North Carolina. Sydney Diane Judy from Waynesboro, Virginia. Dina Khaled from Tucson, Arizona. Samuel Everlyn Kidd from Reading, Pennsylvania. Trenton Kite from Winchester, Virginia. Bryce A.D. LaRue from York, Pennsylvania. Brianna A. Lewis from Blythewood, South Carolina. Madhushana Logis Warren from Ashburn, Virginia. Alistair Catherine Lowe from Blacksburg, Virginia. Caitlin Leanne Luckadoo from Bluefield, West Virginia. Amber Ho Lee from Rockwell, Texas. Deeksha Maturati from Frisco, Texas. Courtney Maddox from Honolulu, Hawaii. Priya Manohar from Burke, Virginia. Pekadeth Jennifer Mayo from Austin, Texas. Jessica Erin Marino from Mechanicsville, Virginia. Kimberly Martin from Oneida, Virginia. Cindela Martinez from Hollywood, Florida. Joseph David McGacken II from Buffalo, New York. Nirzarati Mehta from Timonium, Maryland. Zanabe Memem from Spring, Texas. Felipe Mendoza from Longs, South Carolina. Sarah Madeline Miller from Nineveh, New York. Peyton James Mitten from Eders, Pennsylvania. Jyothi Morjani from Longwood, Florida. Julia Stephanie Morowick from Bel Air, Maryland. Peter Viet Son Wend from Houston, Texas. Chinadum Nakoam Kolam from Staten Island, New York. Alexis Nicole Podesky from Pottsville, Pennsylvania. John V. K. Patel from Del Mar, Maryland. Aslan Simone Patterson from Boston, Massachusetts. Jordan Celeste Paw from South Lyon, Michigan. Bryce C. Pyro from Scottsdale, Arizona. Rebecca Renee Pointer from New Orleans, Louisiana. Naima Cameron Rasul from Roanoke, Virginia. Numa Romani from Mechanicsville, Virginia. Stephen Tyler Richmond from Oswego, New York. Richard Stephen Santiago from Spotsylvania, Virginia. Emily Shire from Freeport, Illinois. Zachary Lewis Schrader from Lima, Ohio. Umamira Faith Sledge from Hampton, Virginia. Daniel Song from Herndon, Virginia. Sarah Elizabeth Stedman from Charleston, South Carolina. Nicholas Stidham from Norcross, Georgia. Karima Malik Strader, Clinton, Mississippi. David Anthony Valenti from Frederick, Maryland. Megan Ashley Voss from Katy, Texas. Ryan West from Columbia, South Carolina. Sarah Wilkins from Apex, North Carolina. Jasmine Alexis Williams from Portsmouth, Virginia. but not least. Emily Janacek from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania.
All graduates, please rise. Bluefield College trustees, President Olive, esteemed faculty, distinguished guests, family, and friends, I present to you the Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences graduates. Mr. Zachary Smith, President of the Alumni Association Board of Directors, comes to the podium to address the class of 2021 and to lead the class in reciting together the Alumni Creed found on the last page of the commencement program.
Thank you, Dr. Flowers. Dr. Olive, Dr. Flowers, faculty, staff, family, friends, and Bluefield College Masters of Arts in Biomedical Science class of 2021. I am so honored to be standing before you today to share in this special occasion with you and your families. As this chapter in the story of your life ends and a new one begins, it is my pleasure to formally welcome you as a member of the Bluefield College Alumni Association. Today, you join an alumni community that is dynamic and thriving network of RAM spread across our country and our world. As alumni, we represent the essence of Bluefield College mission, a mission of passion, a passion to unite, a passion to serve, and a passion for Bluefield College. You will be the embodiment of the spirit in the world, wherever your journey may take you. Today, a new chapter starts in the story of your life. As you maneuver your way through the many ups and downs of life, there will be choices, challenges, joys, and sorrows. But no matter where the road ahead leads, one constant will remain. You will always be part of the Bluefield College family. For all of our graduates today, along with many others who have walked this stage before you, we invite you to join the Alumni Association as we pledge to be proud ambassadors for our alma mater through our generosity and service. At this time, we invite all Bluefield College alumni and graduates who are joining us today to please stand and join with the Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences class of 2021 in reciting the Alumni Creed, which can be found in the back of your commencement program. Please repeat it, or join along with me as I recite the creed. As a member of the Bluefield College Alumni Association, I will take an active role in the life of my college through prayer, advocacy, and gifts of times and resources. Good work ethic, compassion, community involvement, appreciation for others, and the faith in God have become a foundation for me as a student. These values give me a hope and a passion to share the Bluefield College mission with others as I journey through each chapter of my life. I will remember the lighted spire on the hill, and may it remain a symbol to guide me all of my days. May God continue to bless the students, faculty, staff, and the alumni of Bluefield College, and may God bless each of us as we impact our world. As our newest alumni, I encourage you to live boldly, to bring your story to life, never forgetting all the experiences you've had here at Bluefield College and along your career and the things you've learned here. May you work to enrich the lives of others and share in building a better world. On behalf of the Bluefield College Alumni Association, Congratulations on your Master of Arts in Biomedical Sciences, Class of 2021, on a job well done. What an achievement. We are so proud of you. Good luck, and go Rams. Graduates, you may now move your tassels. Congratulations.
I invite everyone to stand, please. The singing of the Bluefield College alma mater printed on the last page of the commencement program will be led by Mr. David Peaty. Following the singing of the alma mater, Dr. Ward Stevens, Associate Professor of Biomedical Sciences, will offer the benediction. I invite all of you to remain standing through the singing of the alma mater, the benediction, and the recessional.
It's really so nice to be standing in front of you today. Unfortunately, it's like the first time and the last time. This past year, I've missed seeing your faces. I've missed putting names to your faces. For example, after the first exam, you already been told how well he did, as I wanted to know, so who's this Chinnydom guy? And what's he look like? I just want to just talk to him, but wasn't able to do that. I miss the noise that students make in the hallways. I miss your questions and just miss being in your presence, because most of the time, you're a lot of fun. And it's also fun to torture you with health policy. I thought I'd do that now, but I won't. But it's been an honor and a privilege to be one of your instructors and to be a small part of your education. And I know my fellow faculty members feel the same way. So wherever you are, virtual or here today, I would just ask that you would just please bow your head for a few minutes to receive these good words. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for these students and their desire to serve others in their profession, to be a blessing to others. We thank you again for their families, friends, professors, and mentors, and others who have helped and encouraged them over the years. We pray that as they continue to pursue their education and careers and their personal lives, that they would not trust in their own understanding and strength, but that they would trust you and your Son, and that they would seek your wisdom and guidance for all areas of their lives. Help them and strengthen them in good times and difficult times to love their family, friends, and enemies as you love them. and that they would honor you in all they do. Bless them and keep them, Father. Shine your face upon them, be gracious to them, and give them the peace that can be found only in a relationship with Jesus Christ, in whose name I pray. Amen. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you.